Adam Levine, what's going on?
What's up?
You're looking mighty sexy today.
Really, I feel like I got hit by a truck, but thank you.
You look fabulous. You do that hit by a truck look very well.
Thank you.
It must be the yoga.
Must be.
Yeah. Now, are you super excited about The Voice? Are you nervous for what it's going to be like with Shakira and Usher? Because, I mean, it must be bittersweet. It must be a little bit sad to say goodbye to some of your old friends.
Yeah, I love those guys. Yeah. And Christina and CeeLo are irreplaceable. You know, in Usher and Shakira, we found two new friends, and they're super amazing, and we love them. Different chemistry, but just as good.
Is it going to be like a family, do you think? Because I remember we got to interview Blake Shelton a while ago, and he said you guys have dinners together, and it was like a very like a family dynamic.
The Voice is a family. You know, it's turned into that. I've talked with people in the past that have had similar situations, like the Idol people or whatever, and as much as that's just revolving doors, still there's some people that have been there a long time, and they say the same thing. It's like, it's a family. It's and that's what perpetuates the show's success, is if it feels like a family and it feels close. You know, right. that's really going to be a huge part of this, and I thankfully, Usher and Shakira were the right choices, yeah. Because as irreplaceable as those two are, still to have Usher and Shakira now, it's like, it feels like really good.
Do you have any say or any word in who your next partner is going to be when you hired Usher and Shakira? Did you make recommendations?
No, we didn't hire anybody.
It wasn't up to Adam. They were like, Adam, so who would you like?
And we were but a pawn in their grand scheme. So now we had no say. Thank God everyone's taste met up at the same place.
Yeah. I mean, what if they hired someone that you like didn't like? Would you have been like, listen, I'm not working with them? Would you have gone all diva on them?
No. I honestly, like, I would have spoken up, but I would have been quickly trumped by the powers that be.
All right.
But you gotta adapt, gotta deal.
So you've got this this fragrance coming out. Now, I always find it interesting because I just don't think that I could go into, I don't know, they bring you like a lab, right? When you come like I feel like you put on lab coats and like goggles.
No, they came to my house actually, and Isaac and all the guys over at ID, they were really cool because basically I came over and we smelled some stuff and picked the ones I liked and changed and modified, and I had a lot to do with the design of the bottle.
Okay.
A lot to do with it, actually. And, you know, it's just fun. It's creative and fun.
So are you going to wear your cologne?
I wear it.
Did you wear cologne before you made the cologne?
No, that was the goal.
Wow.
To create something like that. Because I like Old Spice, like, deodorant. You know, like, I'm like that kind of guy where I'm like, oh, that's all I need. Good. And so I wanted to create something that felt like you were just putting on deodorant. So.
Have you ever had anybody who OD'd on the cologne before? My father is a chronic cologne OD'er.
Yes.
You can smell him coming down the hall. And
yeah, it's an elevator. It's like the guy, it's like, we've talked about this. It's the guy that gets in the elevator and you're just like, yo.
Yeah, you gotta tell them. You gotta let them
What's
know.
What's your deal, man? Like, if you need to smell this crazy, then clearly you have some confidence issues.
Or you're trying to cover something up. Maybe you should just take a shower.
Or you suffer from halitosis or.
That too.
You know.
Well, dude, you already made this room smell good, and it's bugging me just a little bit because you got the clementine peel over there, and I'm looking at it. It's one of my OCD things that when I peel a clementine, it all has to come off in one piece.
That's what this is, a clementine.
Yeah.
No, and they're the best, right?
Because when I peel them off,
there's a little clementine in the scent that I've just created.
Oh, I like.
Just saying.
Look at that. He's just getting creative right now. He's inspired by the clementine.
Sandalwood.
You know what's amazing? Your tattoos. Every time I see them, they get cooler and cooler. That one's my favorite right there.
New tiger.
Yeah, he's so cool.
Thanks.
What's the next tat?
My buddy Brian Randolph.
Is he your tattoo artist?
Extraordinaire.
What's the next one? Where are we putting it?
I think I'm done, man.
No! I want a sleeve on that side.
Well, in my brief experience with acting,
yeah,
I've had to cover them up a couple times.
A lot of work.
Oh, boy. Yeah, that's the worst.
What do you have to do to cover them up when you do a movie? Is it just lots of makeup?
Douse yourself with fucking makeup.
Really?
Yeah, and I'm not down with that.
So now no more because of that? So you obviously have got the acting bug a little bit.
Well,
more.
I mean, I don't want to get more tattoos. If I'm going to be in any more things, I'm probably not going to want to get more tattoos because that's more time in that chair.
You could put them in places where you don't have to cover up, like maybe.
Well, my penis is covered.
Is it?
Yeah, it's actually a snake.
I like that.
It's a cobra, king cobra. And
can we see it?
And it's kind of like half King Cobra, half Homer Simpson.
The bald top.
Exactly.
That's what it is.
Exactly.
Were you a Simpsons fan? I wasn't. Like, the boys were asking me a question about The Simpsons the other day, and I don't
trust people who didn't like The Simpsons.
So you didn't know who Mr. Burns was.
I had no idea.
Get out.
I'm sorry.